Alright, so the first thing you should know about this movie is that if you're expecting it to follow this very safe MCU formula, because they tend to kind of follow this formula, it's not like that. And I mean that in the best way. It feels kind of like its own thing. It's very disconnected from the MCU, but in a good way. It's not like Snake Eyes, where that was very much not a G.I. Joe movie, but at the same time it kind of was. There's little sprinkles and hints of references to, no, this isn't the MCU, because we're referencing this event that happened in this movie, and this character from this movie shows up. But for the most part, you can go in, having not seen most of the MCU movies, and still enjoy it just kind of as an action film. It really much is its own thing. And I say that in the best way. In fact, it kind of harkened back to that phase in the 90s, where we got a bunch of martial arts movies like Street Fighter, Mortal Kombat, Ninja Turtles, but they also kind of modernized it, so it's not necessarily as cheesy as those movies. And the action scenes in this movie are extremely well choreographed. And man, the second half of this movie goes in a very wild and different direction. It suddenly turns into this big fantasy movie with all these really creative, fantastical creatures. And in fact, there's parts of it that reminded me a lot of Pacific Rim, Godzilla, Avatar The Last Airbender, and it was very creative what they did with this. And the scene stealer is Ben Kingsley. Like, we knew he was coming back. This isn't really that big of a spoiler. We knew he was coming back. And he's just as funny as Iron Man 3, and he honestly got the biggest laughs. Now, Awkwafina, I was a little skeptical because I didn't like her that much. And Raya, I barely remember her from Ocean's Eight. It's like, is she gonna ruin this movie? Is she gonna be the one thing about this movie that brings it down? And I mean, she wasn't terrible, but none of her jokes really landed. A couple of them were chuckles, but none of them were like super hilarious. But she held back. She was better than she was Araya. Like, she's more of a supporting character. She doesn't overshadow the character of Shang-Chi at all. And I thought her performance was fine. Some of her humor felt a little forced, but I wasn't as annoyed by her as I was in the other stuff she's been in. So just go and expecting something different from the MCU that doesn't follow the formula. It's a great action movie. It was a lot of fun. I'm very excited to see this because I hope this gets a sequel because I loved this movie. I want to visit this character again. I want to visit this world again. It was awesome. I give this movie an A-, a 9 out of 10, and a 4 out of 5 stars.